So now we have this confidence interval, and it ranges from about 38 to 42. So it's a lot smaller than the one we had calculated when we were basing it off of a sample of size 35. Bigger samples give us more precise estimates by giving us smaller intervals because they shrink the standard deviation of this sampling distribution. So they shrink the interval in which a sample mean might feasibly lie. Now notice that this confidence interval doesn't even contain the original population mean, 37.72. Therefore, it's very unlikely that a random sample of size 250 with a mean of 40 could have been selected by chance. This is evidence for a treatment effect. So with a bigger sample size, we have a smaller interval for which we're pretty sure the true population lies. So with a 95% confidence interval with the sample sizes being 35, we had a pretty big interval. But with a 95% confidence interval with sample sizes being 250, we had a much smaller confidence interval. The greater our sample size, the smaller our confidence interval for the true population parameter after the intervention, and the better we are able to estimate our population parameters.